good girl, Rose.
Happy birthday, Dad. So it's my dad's 60th birthday today. We got the chihuahuas with balloons on. People are gonna say it's animal abuse, but it's not. They're fine. Relax. We love our animals. And Pepito's barking endlessly. Endlessly. So just recently, like this week, Danielle and I started the Carbon Diet app, which is not a diet at all. It's literally just an app that gives you a recommended number of calories to eat based on your activity levels and your fitness level and what kind of workouts you do, how often you work out, etc. A lot of people say, how's that different from MyFitnessPal? MyFitnessPal is just a tracker, so it literally just, you just input your calories for the day. It doesn't really interact with you, but this app does. There's a check-in every week and you put in your weight and body fat and all those things, and it will adjust your macros and calories as you go through the program. So currently I'm at like 1900 calories and I'm set on, my priority is losing fat right now, which really I don't really care. I want to lose fat and gain muscle, but it's hard to do both at the same time. So right now it'd be nice to like drop 5-6 pounds. And Danielle's, wherever Danielle is, she's also on the weight loss, so she's on like 1570 calories a day, and our protein's pretty high. Mine's like 107, hers is about 138. It's going well so far. The app, it's newer of course, so the, sorry for the annoying noise in the background, that's just the chihuahua. But the difference between this and MyFitnessPal is MyFitnessPal has been around for a lot longer, so it has a lot more information in it to input. Like for the Carbon Diet app, I often have to actually manually input the serving size, the calories, the carbs, the fat, and the protein, which is not a big deal, but definitely something that as the app grows more and more, it'll have more in its database. That's my only complaint so far. It's gone well. It's not that hard so far to follow this because I'm on a pretty low calorie or pretty low fat loss regimen. I'm losing, like I have it set to lose 1 pound a week. So that's it. Let's see how it goes. I often get a lot of questions about whether you should change your calories on rest days, or you should, if you overeat one day, should you undereat the next? And I think no. I think if you overeat by 100 calories, it doesn't really throw off your regimen. I think that if you're overeating by 600 calories every single day for 6 months, it's going to throw off your fat loss regimen. People do like intermittent fasting, or they think that'll help them. Just a diet strategy, just another eating strategy. They're all just strategies, intermittent fasting, keto. You know, people think keto is the best. It's just another fad that will fade. I just want to state that vegan is not a fad or a life, or a fad diet or some fat loss diet, just a lifestyle. I choose to be vegan for the animals, not because I think it'll make me lose weight. If anything, it's harder to be a strength athlete and be vegan because you have to get your protein from like many sources to make sure you get all the essential amino acids, like all 9 of them. So yeah, it's definitely not a lifestyle, like, or definitely not like a diet fat loss choice. It's a lifestyle. So yeah, that's that. Today's a rest day for us. I'm eating the same amount of calories today that I would on a day where I did a really hard workout, and I have no regrets. So a couple of different things. Number one, I am not following any kind of like diet regimen. It's really just if it fits your macros. I'm eating any food that I want as long as it fits in those macros for the Carbon Diet. I'm also training 4 days per week on a program called the Strongman Power Builder by Brian Alsrue. It's a conditioning, it's strength, it's kind of conjugate because you got speed and endurance where you have hypertrophy days and then power strength days. So you alternate between those 4 days, one focus on the squat, bench, overhead press, and deadlift. The order goes deadlift, overhead press, squat, bench, because bench is like the least important for strongman. So a lot of event training, a lot of technique work, trying to hit new maxes, trying to hit AMRAPs, a lot of like rep PRs and one rep max PRs, because you'll see both of them in strongman training. There could be a one rep max deadlift where you keep going until you're the last one standing. There could be medleys where you're running with heavy kegs or sandbags or stones or a combination, frames and farmer handles. So it's all about cardio, speed, and strength, because it's usually pretty heavy weight. And then a lot of kind of Metcon-y sort of events. A lot of them feel, it feels like CrossFit for strong people. That's what a lot of people call strongman. So interesting program. I love it. It's really hard. 4 days per week and then 2 days of active recovery, light work on the bike or the rower, foam roller work, lacrosse ball work, mobility, yoga, all that kind of stuff. So that's kind of what my training looks like. And I stick very rigidly to the program. Every once in a while, I'll add something else random onto it. Like, I know I have some issues with my shoulder, so I do extra shoulder mobility or some extra priming for my shoulders, slightly longer warm-ups. And that's pretty much the only changes I do to the program at all. And active recovery might include like a walk as well, or horseback riding because we have horses. So it's a good program. The carbon diet, it's easy to follow and it's super easy to input all the information. So I like that convenience, and we'll see how we're feeling in 4 weeks.